Thank you. I'm standing in my way. How did you do that?
This head of yours is worth its weight in silver.
The mansion has a strange beauty to it, but all such places must eventually come to ruin. Jindosh, it's time to pay for what you've done, and maybe I can find Sokolov.
Stranger, the door is always open to those with the will to pass the threshold. If you're here by appointment, then proceed and bide your time. Otherwise, I'd be remiss if I didn't inform you about the defensive mechanisms employed here, which are quite formidable. Many have entered without invitation, for reasons as myriad as the fish in the ocean. But of those who've dared to explore further, very few have found their way back out.
Someday I'll have a bureaucratic army typing writs of execution for my enemies. Who would build something like this? And why? Jindosh.
Welcome, visitor. My home is always open. It's one of my great curiosities, seeing how the common mind navigates these shifting rooms. I'm Karen Jindosh, but you must know that. I invite you to continue, stranger. Just come up the stairs. Meet with me face to face in the upper hall.
Commencement refocus.
Hello? That's it. You're almost there. Come in through the gallery so I can see you. I expected the courtesy of seeing you by this point.
I see you, I've worked out who you are. Not a hired cutthroat. Your clothes are too fine. An aristocratic thrill seeker? That's closer. You've trained with weapons formally, but you're not a salon fencer. There's a bit of back alley in your movements. All that, and you have your father's eyes, your imperial majesty. Welcome, Lady Emily Caldwin.
Impressive, Jindosh. Then you must also know why I'm here.
I'd assume my involvement with the Duke brought you to my door. Or maybe you're after washed-up Anton Sokolov, comfortably residing in the assessment chamber. Either way, come find me and take whatever it is you seek. But if you fall, I'll have your body carried to my lab for dissection and study. Until either comes to pass, your secret is safe with me.
I'll see you soon, Jindosh.
Until then.
Soldiers, there's an interloper in my home.
Before he has a chance to get on them, wake him up. He'll be on my time. The Jindosh clock works, soldier. Marvel at the triggering soldier's heart to metallic skeleton and razor-sharp blade. My greatest creation.
Ah, the space behind the walls.
The machine is running at low speed.
Increasing oil tank temperature.
Somehow I got out of that alive.
Sounds like someone's in the building. Should we wait for the clockwork?
It'll wake up on its own if a fight breaks out. They're blind, but they can still hear.
Creepy to know they might be listening to us. Can they understand what we're saying?
No. No more than an audiograph machine can.
I feel sorry.
Poor Sod took my place on the Bloodfly crew. Always worth it.
What? The window. Maybe the wind or something. Huh? So he says, keep alert. And I says, I am alert. I've been alert. And he says, yeah, but this time I refer.
Alert. Always.
Stand clear! I'm bringing up the arc pylon!
Are you there? I can't sense your weight on the floor or the sounds of your breathing anymore, but it seems like a reasonable guess that somehow you got beyond the inner walls of the house.
So this is how it works.
Prices, the man wouldn't keep us waiting.
There's only one Kirin Jindosh. He can charge whatever he likes. Besides, you're rich enough to afford a couple of the clockworks. I happen to know you've doubled your fortune since Duke took over the silver mines.
Lower wages means higher profits, but it's my time that's precious. I'm not used to waiting.
Neither am I. When was the last time someone had me waiting for more than an hour? I can't remember. It's almost titillating.
How many clockworks did you say there were? It's a numbered set, if I recall.
It is indeed, but 3646? Very exclusive, whatever the card is. Everything at the Cotton Club will breathe within me.
Hello? Are you there?
There he goes again. Who do you suppose he's talking to?
It explains the delay, at least.
Lady Pinoli. And that's all it took. One from me. What a bastard.
How many people am I gonna see get hanged this month?
Mechanical soldiers, moving walls. Most people are happy just doing a job. Inventors.
He didn't want his teeth
like
broken
normal people.
Maybe you shouldn't have opened his mouth.
Kid. These days, I'm leaving the city. Back to the countryside for me.
This won't take long.
You'll be the sadistic crime killer.
What's going on here? I don't want to die.
Huh? What?
So even bystanders fall to your wrath. What a tenacious monster you are. I'll enjoy dissecting your brain, discovering the poisons within.
Cruelty is this. There's another choice here. Assuming Jindosh's electroshock machine works. Not sure I'd call it mercy.
Indicates criminal profile.
Then get back.
unambiguous enemy. Switching to alternative tactical mode. Triggering electrostatic discharge. Stand clear. Combat protocol meet. Enemy at rear playback. Combat protocol 6.
Now that your last moment, the last vision you behold is a work of scintillating industry. The very pinnacle of invention.
If this plays, the machine is recharging the magnetic coil. Extra diagnostic playback.
Sokolov.
Something.
Can it be? Is that young Emily Caldwin?
Anton, save your strength. I came to take you out of here.
Jendosh has bigger plans than you know. An army of his clockwork soldiers. It would be the end.
I'm going to visit Jendosh too, old friend.
Make a note. Remove this playback after the final field test. Machine is running at low speed.
Chamber reconfiguring. Standing by. Configuration beam. Adapting to layout.
Registered. General detection state.
Configuration imported.
Okay, return to routine operation.
Kneel down!
not safe. Not meant for human passage.
Electrostatic discharge.
Okay, at least Anton is safe. Now for Jindosh.